Welcome back, Generals. It's time for a little assault up Kettle Run. I'm Major General Difficulty in version 1.28.4 of the J&P Mod. I decided to do something a little different for this battle. It should be fun, but may not be pretty. Before we get started, I want to say thank you for taking the time to check out any of my materials related to the game. I hope that you find something to help you achieve success in your own campaigns. Do not hesitate to ask questions in the comments. Be aware that Colonel, Brigadier General, and Major General Difficulties all share an AI profile. Legendary has its own profile. Therefore, things that you see me do should easily translate to lower difficulties, but may not work in Legendary or be suboptimal. My two career points from Malvern Hill went into training, giving me a total of 6. Kettle Run is an uphill battle in the dark with terrible visibility and a fairly short timer. I prefer to attack downhill, and the visibility in the upper right of the battlefield isn't too bad. Therefore, I let my infantry and artillery set this one out, and I just took skirmishers and my cavalry so I could move quickly. All of my skirmishers here have the pickets perk, except for the No Star. Grimes has 59 Sharps rifles, and all the rest have Harper's Ferries. John Gibbon has 1st Division with Grimes and Sullivan. McClellan has Froebel and Keyes. U.S. Grant has Smith, Braxton, and Kite. Brown has Frank, Martin, and Bernie. One of my melee cav has Palmettos, and the other one has Colt 45s. One of my carbine cav has Merrills, and the other has 59 Sharps carbines. Following Malvern Hill, the AI was reinforced with one corps of 23,700 men, and an additional 7,800 veterans. With the full clear from Malvern, the AI army size decreased by 8K, training increased by 4%, and the armory by 2%. The AI will have 16,036 troops and 39 guns before splits. I will have 7,670 men and 0 guns, so I'm outnumbered a little more than 2-1. Ideally, I'll be able to isolate a few of the AI units and turn the tables quickly with some captures and shatters by my cav. I'll start by moving everyone up the far right side. I need to keep an eye out for skirmishers that are hiding in the woodlines. Now, this is the first time that I've ever fought this battle with just skirmishers and cavalry. So it may be a little messy, and it may be unrealistic to get a full clear. If nothing else, it'll be a learning exercise in feasibility. Kettle Run is one of my least favorite battles, so as long as I get a good win, I'll move on to Thoroughfare Gap. The AI skirmisher should be the maximum size. I need to rely on getting as much firepower on each AI unit as possible to negate their size advantage, then use my KF to charge once they're wavering and routing. There might be skirmishers in the wooded area in the top center, so I want my KF to stay grouped together while moving across. Change of plans. I need to back these guys out of here and flank from above. All right, this unit is committed to charging, so I'll try to eliminate it. He's routed and broken, but just doesn't want to give it up. So he shattered a detached and a dedicated skirmisher and captured one brigade plus the supply wagon. So we're off to a decent start. Now for the artillery, another brigade, and some more skirmishers. Thank you. got another charging brigade. We'll see how it goes. Sure doesn't look pretty, but things are moving along. If I can take this routing brigade and these few skirmishers, I should be good. My skirmishers all have at least 400 range weapons and 125 fire rate, so I should be able to rout the last few infantry brigades off the VP. I'm getting pressed for time, so this might get interesting. There goes one more to go. Ah! I really hate taking these casualties, but I need to take this VP soon. I got the win at the last moment. I had about 305 men killed, 944 wounded, and 117 missing, for a total of 1,366 casualties. The AI had 4,871 casualties and 3,066 captured. I captured quite a few carbines, 14 Napoleons, and a brigade's worth of Lorenz rifles. Thank you so much for spending some of your valuable time watching today. I hope you found something useful for your own campaigns, and I wish you much success, generals.